Hey, you guys. It's the day after Thanksgiving, and as far as I know, it's still called Black Friday, I think. So many places started Black Friday like weeks ago, I think. I realize I'm out of the loop and not updated on. What the new rules are or what the new things are. I guess I could call this a happy day after Thanksgiving. By the time you see it, it might be the day after, maybe 2 days after. Anyways, we had wonderful sparkling, non-alcoholic red grape juice cocktail champagne. We brought out the champagne glasses. This one has a little crack in it, so I'm not going to fill it too high. Cheers. So now Welch's has their version of like the Martinelli. Was a lot of fun. I guess we have good news and bad news for Thanksgiving Day info. Bad news is, remember the new roasting pan or turkey pot my daughter got so happy about? It was too big for the oven, and the oven door wouldn't close. Couldn't believe it. Has never happened. So I stood there in the kitchen in shock. In fact, I was in such shock. I didn't even really take a picture or film it to even like show on Facebook, because that would have been my Thanksgiving Day post. Oh. I knew my daughter was gonna make a smart and final visit. So she got me three of these roaster pans and some of the heavy duty foil paper. So I brought it in the kitchen, and I saw there were three. I thought to myself, why did she get three? I didn't need three. Bigger than beans. I needed three. Because I forget the weight of the turkey. Just, even though it's a heavy, it's a larger, heavier pan. The weight still makes the pan kind of collapse. So then I was so appreciative that she got three. And you just covered it with a foil paper. And everything turned out just like normal. Crisis averted. So she happened to be somewhere. And look what they gave her. You know, the owner somewhere she was at with her friend gave her instant home COVID testing. So, I really haven't dug through it all, but she said it's immediate COVID testing things. If you think you have COVID, you can test yourself and get results within minutes. Now, is that just a comfort? Just so thoughtful that they gave her those. I guess they own a business and my daughter, they knew each other because they had closed their business. They had all these. They were giving them to people. And I think my daughter said there's 30 of them in there. Maybe I misunderstood. So it's nice to know those are available. And between my daughter being so thoughtful, it was such a lovely Thanksgiving day to give thanks for daughter being thoughtful and everything she did. And then she brought over the test. Neighbor had brought a bag, Thanksgiving bag, and inside was the Lysol spray, the Lysol wipes, and a lovely Thanksgiving, you know, tote bag, and the most delicious cookies. They were like a butter cookie, and it tasted like pie shell crust. It was delicious. Happy Thanksgiving. Wishing you an extra big helping of happiness. And it just, it was so thoughtful. And again, I'm always reminded of when you do something kind, nice towards someone else, it makes me want to think, how can I be kind to someone else? That was really thoughtful. Okay. Wanted to mention, oh, look at this. This is like sparkling blush. This almost looks like a wine, like, or a rosé something from Martinelli's. A gold medal. My sister found this at Vaughn's weeks ago. These are hard to find. I'm also looking for a Martinelli's blush. So we found the, rosé. We found the sparkling blush from Martinelli's. Now I'm looking for the sparkling rosé. Look at how fancy that is. Wait, so we might do this one for Christmas. Never had it before. And like I said, it's a little hard to find. But Vaughn's did have it. So, okay, I wanted to tell you about my stuffing. Good news and bad news about the stuffing. Good news for me, it was gluten-free, and it was very good. It was like any kind of traditional stuffing. Bad news for my husband. I neglected to really read the ingredients, because once I knew it was gluten-free, I thought, oh, good. Remember, he has a milk allergy. In here, near the top of the ingredients, is whey protein. That's milk. Where is it? And egg whites. He's allergic to eggs, so there's egg whites in there. Where's the whey protein? Brown rice. Excuse me, there was another item with a whey protein. This was bad for him because of the eggs and the rosemary. He woke up with a headache and I checked his blood pressure and it was quite high for him. Rosemary will give you high blood pressure if you add rosemary to stuff, so just be careful. I just have it handy for on days when we have low blood pressure. We check our blood pressure and it's low and we don't feel well. We feel dizzy. I have the spice so that we can use it to raise the blood pressure. So that's how I know. And when he woke up with a headache, I realized, well, it's either because of the egg allergy you have or the rosemary. So buyer beware. I hope you learned something. If you have somebody that suffers from low blood pressure, you can maybe have some ground rosemary. We get ours at Smart and Final. It's a bottle of rosemary grounded to like a fine powder. And you can sprinkle that on food to help blood pressure. And then the other item of disaster for my husband was turkey gravy. At the last second, as he was eating it, he was just loving it. I go, oh, it's just this old Kroger can of turkey gravy, and I'm looking at it. And I see on the ingredients near the top, it says whey protein, which means milk. And I didn't say anything. So here we are the day after Thanksgiving. So we'll see how he feels. It's a real adjustment to, going from just eating and drinking everything you want. And then, all of a sudden, it seems like overnight, you have to really scrutinize ingredients. I always mention I have knee pain. I am loving these salon paws. I've heard of them for so long. Never thought that much of them. Always, I thought of Asper cream, you roll it on. It has lidocaine. This also has 4% lidocaine, the same as Asper cream. But there's something about this patch, and it's a pretty good size patch, really covers your whole knee well. I can put this on the start of the day and almost go through my whole day with this patch on. Though somewhere on here, it says 8 hours. It works for 8 hours. It really does. It works for even more than 8 hours. Anyways, if possible, if you have some medical tape, you know, that it's like a stretchy tape they use in hospitals, that's an added extra, because when you start sweating, it's easy for these patches to fall off or get loose. So I picked up some. You can find it like at Rite Aid or Walgreens or CVS. Years ago, I remember getting some on Amazon. In fact, I bet if I dig through the drawer, I'll find. It was like a 10-pack of those medical. It's like a fabric tape. They work the best, really well. And for some reason, I needed them years ago. Anyways, wonderful, wonderful for knee pain. And of course, I'm guessing back pain. And just don't be frustrated if it falls off. Just get some of that medical tape for skin. And this, I was thinking, this is the cream. I don't know about this, but I was thinking about it, like, look and see what's more cost effective, the pre-made patches, or just like make your own patch, like get some of this cream and get a jumbo, you know, a Band-Aid, and put some of the cream on the Band-Aid and then put it on your knee or your back. So as soon as I figure out what's more cost effective, that's what I want to try with that. And what else do I have here? Oh, these little mini. These are another fun thing. These mini soda pop cans. Now over here, I have a mini Canada Dry. I don't know if you can see. You see those? Mini Canada Dry. I'm not sure if I'm going to be using this pack, or I'm going to give that for a little gift for somebody, but these are so much fun, I can't tell you. And they even have, I saw Coke now for the holidays has Santa Claus, they have different holiday cans with holiday artwork. I got a thing of Sprite, let's see, Canada Dry, Coke Zero, Sprite Squirt, Dr. Pepper. And I think I even got a ginger ale. It was zero, just like Coke Zero. It was ginger ale, zero. Just really happy with those little Coke cans. My niece just, she thinks she's really something, because again, they're 7 ounces, and so. I know it's nicer to give a kid that's smaller can than the larger 12-ounce. And I'm really having a potato chip. Craving. Now see, Lay's does say gluten-free. See that GF right there? So I might have to break into that later. I'm really craving potato chips. But I read an article that the most sure gluten-free potato chip is the Cape Cod. And that even though they say gluten-free, they suspected a little teeny tiny little bit of gluten. I read an article somewhere, but anyways. So this is my day after Thanksgiving video chat. news and my bad news. So I'm not sure when this will go up. Maybe actually one day after Thanksgiving, the day I make it, or the